Hello, welcome. So this is one of the better tycoon game, simulation game, crossroads simulation, whatever you want to call it. But as fun as it is, this is not a full release. This is half of it is early access, let's just say like that. So the game has been crashing, has gameplay breaking bugs, and you need to save a lot. So if you want to buy this game, just think about these things before. I suggest wait another month or two before you buy it, but hey, let me show you what you can do in the game. I'll skip all the story because I just want to get into the gameplay because it's kind of rough to explain it. So let's just play the game, I'll show you some tips, I'll show you how to do some basic things and then you can decide if it's worth it. Because if you even stray out of the tutorial by, let's say, I don't know, 1000 coins, you basically lose the campaign. And you don't even know it because this is such a hard game to balance, sometimes you have enough resources, but you don't have, let's say, personnel, or you don't have space.
The great, the king, the investigation was meanwhile,
the story is great, as I said, but it's not really so relevant to your career as a crossroads innkeeper. Alright, so let's just follow the tutorial. Here is your message. Okay, so to expand the room, okay, let's start from the beginning. This has the mug icon on it, which means it's a main hall, so you need the main hall. Click on it, now you can expand the main hall. Oh, see what, this is what I mean. Okay, let's do this from the beginning, because the game wants you to do it in a very, very specific way. Click on that. Click on that, see? And now it works. Don't go overboard, only do one of it because it's kind of expensive. And after that, you just have to wait. This is building, you can sell it right now and you'll get all the money back.
Your employee is leveling up. This life turned out
wow, he's
not
crazy.
To be so bad.
But happy. So if you sell the room right now, you get nothing in return for it. So sell it while it's under construction, otherwise you will get zero money. I keep saying this because it happened to me and I failed the game. Here is your objectives, now we just need to place a few rooms. Rooms, I mean tables, whatever. Same thing, right? So let's put one there, one there. One there, that should be enough, right? Now the game tells you to put benches, but the benches have to be put right near the tables. So it's not like this, or like this, or like this. It's exactly aligned with the tables. Three tables are enough. Now it says you need light, because without light... Okay, So it wants me to put... Again, you just have to see what the game asks of you. Candles in the room, well, maybe I want to put a torch. Do you have a problem with that? Yes, you have a problem with that. Let's just buy the expensive one. It produces a lot of light, but it's expensive, so later on you won't be able to use it. But it's pretty. Let's see, now it probably wants me to put the barrel. For storing alcohol? That's great. You get the money from it. And now you advance the plot, so remember, this is the campaign, so this is a very, very long save file. So don't try to go crazy with it, this is what I'm saying. Just do what the tutorial tells you and wait for your objectives.
The boy's gonna be just fine.
And I just want to use intimidation this time. Even though wisdom seems to be the easier option, but sometimes you don't get all the options in a dialogue. So let's go for intimidation. Yeah, we're intimidating people.
This place is so boring, it hurts.
We are intimidating him. Shut up and go away. He's basically the person who owns all the wine trade in the country. The continent has three countries. This is one of them. The king was killed. He controls the wine country and wants to be the king. No, no. Let's find someone who can sell us the wine. We can ask for a passion. Well, okay, let's do it like that. So now we have to place a board over here. Like this. And this will give you quests later, I think. Let's put it over here then. Oh, come on, game. Don't be so rude. I'm just trying to save some space. Now let's go forward with the game. And even if it seems easy in the beginning, oh, it will get so much more complicated because this is all the space you can use, I think. Sorry about that, I'm still sick. So let's wait until the notice board has something for it. Just read this. Okay, secret note. And he'll do that as soon as he finish, I don't know, cleaning his mugs or something. Did someone put the secret note again? Okay. Sometimes you just don't know how the game works, so you have to improvise. Quest is nothing. Finally, he goes and puts the message. That's just great. So now we need to do something in the... Actually, this is about upgrading your thingy.
I'm not too old for this shit.
Oh, he puts the message a lot of times. That's bad. So let's see the journal, break up the monopoly. And now we have to level up, but I don't remember where that thing is. Oh, because it's here. Right. So we are unlocking the outlaws right now. So we can serve outlaws and peasants basically. Yeah, speed up time. Also, I'll try to cover the basics of it. Yeah, he looks at you friendly, so I don't know, maybe that's just for flavor. Let's claim the money. These are your skills, because you have skills for some reason. This has so much content, but sadly most of it is broken, so let's try to do all the tutorials, because the tutorials will give you a bit of money and it will be a little easier for newer people to learn. So she wastes time. But she's also speedy, so I guess that's a good combination. So she was a server. You have to click on this to see what type of employee you want. So if you click on this, it will show you the kitchen staff. If you click on, let's say, the servant, it will show you these people. But then you can just go to hire and hire new people. She has a sword, why? Brave. So let's see. Yeah, let's also hire Cassandra, even though we don't need anyone right now. Also, this is how you introduce new recipes to the inn, sort of saying. And now we're prepared to actually make some money. The distressed are the peasant, basically, so now we just have to sell the wine. Let's put a few extra tables, because we have nothing to do for now. As I said, it's more important to have the right furniture, so don't go overboard with your spending. So, let's put something like this. I don't know, there is no ideal way to do it, it's just a matter of opinions. Also, let's put a few torches, because people will complain. They say, "Yo, it's too dark, I hate it here." No, it's not too dark. This is kind of the easier way to do it. Can we put one here? Yes. Okay, that should be enough for the beginning. Now, let's speed up time and let's wait for people to come to us. Sadly, we don't have any more wine because we never got wine.
Your employee is leveling up.
So you need to get more. Oh, so this is hidden. Okay, so some of the recipes are hidden. So we're making some money, but we're going to sell out everything. Also, for the dishwasher, you just need the thingy, but it's an outside thingy. But you can put it anywhere, so you can just, you know, put it over here. Generally, I put it over here because the stairs are accessible through that part. I like it here, closer to the door, so he doesn't waste time, you know, walking a lot. Now, we need also a drudge, which is basically someone who just does the basic cleaning and basic stuff. Go to hire, unclick those. And we don't have anyone available for that job. So probably this is randomized, of course.
It's already been 5 minutes since I had a drink. How awful.
Oh, I failed and I lose money, so usually you gain money. So if you want to make it with the right choices, just pick wisdom, because wisdom is a lot easier. But as I said, I want to play intimidation as a challenge run. So we should get a drudge, right? Orcaholic. What is a drunk card? Well, I guess they balance themselves out. Don't expand your crossroads in too much in the beginning. Just wait until you get the right memos for the game. Okay, since we're almost full, I'll add another table to the mix. Yes, I know, it's not properly aligned. Don't buy the chairs, they're too expensive for now. Buy them later when you can actually make a good looking tavern for the people who have money. These are just outlaws, peasants. You know, common people. And I usually expand my tables as soon as I need more space. You can also praise your workers.
I lift a salad.
So the drudge will automatically wash the mugs, and the mugs are shown here, so we have 22 clean mugs. That means we don't need anything else for the moment, just to praise our employees.
What can I do for you?
So praise them, because later on you'll be so angry at them.
Your employee is leveling up.
So to go to the second floor, that's not very clear, you just have to click this little button. Now the game wants me to build some storage. So let's see, where is the storage thingy? So it's the shelf. But usually I just put the barrel here because first of all you need drinks and then the barrel. And then the shelf, I mean. Okay, easy does it, right? Also remember to go down a level because you can't build anything on that elevation except for that particular room. Now it wants us to put outside a pallet. I guess you could put it inside maybe, but it's a lot of space, so I just put it here, see, near the door. Alternatively, if you want to go straight to your storage, you can put it somewhere here. But usually he'll pick up the wine and put it in the barrel right there. Don't worry, later on you can play and mess around with these things, but this is the beginning of the game, so don't worry about it. As you can see, I'm playing only on the fastest option. Oh, I can get wine now, sure. So let's get 10 wine, 860 gold, and as you can see, they all delivered it to us. I like these things. So this is the map, this is where
your
you are.
Reputation is improving.
This is kind of like the edge of the country. And you can send people to go and buy stuff there, you can send people to train, you can send people to get resources or rare materials. But for now, this is everything we can do. Hey! Our wine is here. So let's see what the next task is. I did that, so I just need to order 10 units of wine again. Yes, I did this one a bit too early, but don't worry, we need all the wine we can get. Most of the tutorial phase of the game, you'll just have to sell the wine, even though this is not very profitable. here are your guests. Yes, more wine. And this is how much money you are making. Expenses, income, profits, and how much distress are coming. Anyway, you understand this stuff, basic logic. Yeah, not for me. I actually took about 2 hours to learn the game. So now we just have to wait for that stupid Duke to come and tell us he wants to steal our profits and our wine or something like that. Don't do anything else. I mean, this is just fine as it is. The last table isn't filled, so I won't build another one. Steadily but surely we're getting there. So much progress, so much work. Don't spend your money, because you can upgrade this in to a very high degree. But since you don't have the necessary items like a better menu choice or more resources, it will just be empty space that you'll waste. The room looks tall. Okay. Now we just have to sell as much wine as we can. I mean, we can make the room a little better or make it prettier, but we don't have the necessary items. Also go to your journal and maybe pick a new skill. So let's unlock the tips. More storage objects. Well, I guess we can do that. But that's not really needed right now. So if you unlock that, the guests will start leaving tips, which will increase your profits and it will make it a little easier on you. The wait was too long.
I live to serve.
This place is so boring, it hurts.
It's so much easier with the other choices. I have to go into intimidation, but... Oh, it actually worked, okay. If it doesn't work, he will come up with soldiers. So if he comes with soldiers, just lock all the doors and they'll get bored and they'll run away. So that's how you deal with the soldiers. Just lock all the doors before they get inside your inn. Otherwise, they'll start destroying your inn, they'll start stealing your supplies and stuff like that. What do you mean waiting for too long? Where are my servant girls? Or waitresses? And Martin is also one of the servers. I guess they're feeling a little lazy. I won't hire another person because that was just the first flow of customers. After that flow, they'll start, you know, arriving slower. Yes, it's a self-service inn. Don't worry, you have enough money to survive it. You just need to wait for the mission to finish. At this point, we will save our game. Save your game often. You do have auto-saves, but usually you want to save every 5 or 10 minutes. You'll get used to it after your game crashes a few times. Leveling up.
I'm not too old for this shit, but I'm getting close.
What can I do for you?
Okay, good service. As you can see, they are starting to speak much better of us. Special treat, kick out, watch and about. So yeah, I think in the future you'll have special guests, or you might want to pay closer attention to a faction. Like the nobles or the townsfolk, or even the...
Your employee is leveling up.
Or even the outlaws, if you want to focus more on them. Okay, we can sell as much wine as possible right now, because we're just on the high roll.
You don't have proper equipment.
You don't say. How about if I build more? Don't worry, the game is a little annoying like that. So let's build more, but just to be on the safe side, let's say this is a storage for alcohol and just to be on the safe side, as I said. He comes again, we have to shoo him away. Probably will fail with intimidation. As you can see, his people are coming to destroy our inn. By that I mean his guards. No, no, then close all the other doors. Sometimes they don't go through the doors, so it's weird, I don't know. So this is what happens. Yes, this is what happens when it bugs out. So usually they don't get through the doors if they're locked, so my game crashed. I'll just keep this in the video because, as I said, the game has really big problems. So saving a lot and waiting for the right moment to do something is crucial. Again, we're just selling wine, so nothing major happened. That's a cute laughter. So let's put more wine barrels in here. Let's see, store
your
alcohol.
Your employee is leveling up.
Later you'll have even more ingredients and more food items, so it'll be even funnier. More fun and funnier. Our objective is still the same, deal with the Duke. And you see, they crashed my game just because they, I don't know, entered at the same time or did something weird. Hey, waitress, go there. Also, keep an eye out on your clean marks. This is another important aspect of the game.
There's too little food to feed all the patrons.
Why doesn't it let me go into my inventory?
Your employee is leveling up.
Okay. I only have 5 or 4 clean marks, which is a problem. They are just hauling the wine outside inside, and that's why they don't have time to wash the dishes or something like that. I don't know, sometimes you need to hire more people, but you don't need them after you completed your task. So don't worry about it. If something doesn't go right...
Profit and pleasure.
Pause the game. Look at that, angry soldiers. Don't worry, they're having a great time inside. And the game will bug out again because they are just... they're just, you know, annoying. Don't let them go to your storage because that's where... What? She fell down the stairs. They usually make a mess in the storehouse. So people can't enter and they can't leave. What are they doing? Are they writing graffiti on the walls? Oh, whatever will I do? The door is closed. I'm stuck here. I'll just let them... Ooh, that's bad. Hey, don't destroy my furniture. Let's see what they do. Actually, let's just let them outside. Go outside, guys. And Martin will just come and fix everything. Let me out. This is not funny. They didn't destroy a lot of things, but at least the game didn't crash. So I'll just play until I make the kitchen. And after that, you can basically do everything else yourself if you still want to buy the game. But you can see it has so much potential and the graphics are right. The feeling of the game is right. It's fun, it's atmospheric, it has the peasantry, it has the bandits. This is a bandit, of course. You can also have fun with the viewing modes, I mean the camera angles. That table will break, let's repair it. Or that chair, or bench was okay. It's a bench. That's wait, is that locked? Oh, that was locked for some reason. And here he comes again. It's a pleasure to see you, my friend. So yeah, you might want to go for something softer. I think he likes deception more, but it's a 50-50 for intimidation. Okay, we intimidated him and he will leave us alone. He usually does this about 2 or 3 times. But you can just save and reload your game if you fail 1 or 2. And sadly, that's about it. You have to wait until you unlock the other stuff. If you don't do the tutorial, it will probably be easier for you, but at the same time harder, because some things are just set in stone in the game. If you try to deviate from your set path, you'll destroy your inn and then you'll just be upset. Because the game has a really bad downward spiral.
This one's on the house.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's see. Right now I don't think we're having any problems. Poor service.
I'm not too old for this shit, but I'm getting close.
1 hour left. That means we have to sell more wine, and when Robin Hood comes back, he'll actually give us money. If we get the skill check. Good services. That's what I like to hear. And now we just have to wait until this guy enters our little inn and tells us he's amazing and he likes to give us more deals. 100% intimidation. Yes, this is how you make money. Okay, this is the kitchen tutorial, which again, it will prove very hard for people because they have to build a new room. Let's just get the money and let's see, do I have enough wine? I have enough wine for now. He's fixing the bench, okay. So, we need a kitchen hand. So let's do this. Okay, he's smart, so he should be a good kitchen hand. Hire the kitchen hand, and this is where things get out of control. So let's add 2 dishes to the menu. Now, usually I add the dishes that are for the people that are already visiting me, so... The barbarian stew is a little too hard, so I like to put the grilled sausage. And the bread soup, because the peasants like it. But to be honest, bread soup is kind of delicious anyway. So this will probably be my kitchen, because this is currently unused space, so you don't want to build too much. Now let's see, I will make it something like this. That's enough, don't go overboard, you'll go broke, even though you have a lot of money. So let's go to the kitchenware. So what does this do? Bad quality? Fast. Well, I guess we'll just take the cauldron, and as I said, I like to put it somewhere decent. Okay, let's move it over there. Also, we need the wood holder, relatively close to it. And you can also move the furniture around. To move the furniture around, you just select it, see? Come on, I know you can do it. Oh, let's just put it over there. And as a side note, I just like to have 2 of them. In case people start coming to me with a lot of passion. Okay, and that was basically the kitchen tutorial. Cheap prices. Yes, wood, where did I get wood? Okay, transport cost, okay, I got it. How do you order the drudge to cut down planks outside? I have no idea, so that needs water first of all. Well, I guess we can do this.
You don't have enough mugs. Your guests can't drink.
See, this is why I do that. I guess you have to order the wood in the beginning. So let's hire another servant thing, the drudge. Oh, Okay, he's smart, so let's have that guy.
Your employee is leveling up.
Now let's go to the map and actually order the wood. Also need sausages, so the sausage is 140, and this is on your menu, that's why it's showing up like that. Strange meat. Onions, firewood. Oh, I guess I need firewood. So let's get the firewood first of all, and this let's compare some prices. So it's 41. Okay, that was a mistake then. Oh, it was not, it's 38. How much do you ask for sausages? 217. Incredible farmers. How much do you ask for sausages, or you don't have them? No, they don't have sausages, but they have bread for 49.59. Okay, you get the general idea. This is not the best way to do it, but as he said, you have transport costs, so let's buy more. Decorations, outlaws, weapons, chain skulls, flowers, farming, okay. Let's finish our business over here. So we have bread, sausages, and I think we need onions. So the onions are how much here? 49. Come on, let me see the onions. 48. Oh, that's how you send someone to learn the recipes. Bread is... Actually, I should have bought the bread from that guy. Onion is 49, so... Yeah. It doesn't really matter in the beginning, but you should get the hang of it sooner or later. Okay, now let's go back home. You can always check your recipes here. So it needs sausages, water and bread. I have bread and sausages. Actually, let's order another portion of sausages. Yeah, 140, but let's check the prices.
Your inn is dirty.
They don't even have them, so I guess this is the best choice, the bandit cap for the sausages. Bandit sausages. A complete mystery, right? Some discount, okay, that's enough. What do you want me to do here? Oh, decoration, okay, that's not so bad. But first of all, remember, you can level up and unlock new stuff. So let's unlock new stuff, more storage objects. And let's go upstairs. If I remember correctly, that's for alcohol. That's for alcohol.
There's too little food to feed all the patrons.
They'll handle it, don't worry. So, I guess... Not being really explained, I guess I'll have to use the shelves for storage. And this will just be the general storage of everything. So you can choose what to store in there, but for now I'll just leave it on default. As you can see, we have delicious bread over there, firewood, delicious meat and sausages.
Food to feed all the patrons.
Okay, our kitchen hands should be hard at working right now. He has the firewood, as you can see. So it's also a basic thing about, you know, just handling all your business. Poor service. I think I should hire another server at this point. Another druid would also be helpful. Sly. Okay, let's he seems a little better. Now he, all of them can carry all the things. They also need to prioritize cleaning. I think the drudges clean the place. So what do you want me to do? Decorate the inn. Place a chopping block. Okay, let's do that as well. So as I said, normally I like it something like this. I hope it doesn't mess up the well. Also, they want me to decorate. Okay, let's decorate this wall to the maximum. Put that shield, okay, this is kind of boring because you have to be so precise with the movement. I guess they love the chains and stuff. Also, let's put some skulls. Banister, well, that's a bad place to put that. Fishing net, well, this is a great one. The fishing net will be used over there. What else can I put on the walls? Yeah, barrels, I don't like them. Okay, let's place a few flower barrels here. No, the place is not so dull as before. Oh, and as soon as I say that, they contradict me. It's a pelt, okay, let's put the pelt over there, no? Okay, this is for the scoundrel, so let's put it over here. About here. Okay. Perfect fit. Kate with flowers. Oh man, they are really going to do this, right? Flowers, skulls and chains. We have everything in here for everyone. This is what multiculturalism means. He said it. Well, I guess I can't do that, but hey, it was worth a shot. So this is also a fancy thing, so let's put more shields because shields are better. Case of attack, grab a shield. Okay, let's just leave that wall as it is. So that was done. Now let's see if we are actually cooking something here. That's bad. What? Don't I have the onion transport yet? Wait a minute. Maybe I just need more pallets outside. Something must have happened to my onion transport, so let's order another batch. Because they're needed in both of the recipes, so let's get the onion transport. No, but I don't have the onions yet. Something must have happened. I don't know, they tripped over and fell.
Your patrons say your inn is dirty.
It's not dirty, it's just atmospheric. So after I'm finished with the food, then I'll end the video. But hey, you can see how complicated and fun this game can be. Finally, we have
Did
the
I
onions.
Burn something?
What can I do for you?
You don't have enough plates. Your guests can't eat.
What do you mean I need plates? Where do I get the plates then? Didn't say anything about plates. Oh, I need to order the plates? So those are the mugs. Probably the bandits have them because they have everything that you need in the beginning.
You don't have proper equipment to store some of the resources.
Okay, that's just rude, man. So I need something to store the plates. Well, that's seriously something. So let's go to facilities. What do I need to store the plates? The shell should be okay. Game, you're trying to trick me. The game is trying to trick me. So let's see. No, they actually are washing the dishes and the mugs. Transport with supplies has arrived. Wooden dishes. Yeah, that was so hard to make, right? The mugs have arrived. The drinks are ready. We're out of money almost. But I have the plates. Why is the mission not ready? Well, I guess they need to put the plates on something, but I don't know what.
You don't have enough plates. Your guests can't eat.
So it's not from there. Well then I don't understand. I ordered the plates. They are right here. Come on. Guys, go and take them inside the inn. No, they're not taking the plates inside the inn. So this is again one of the chokeholds that I was mentioning. Sometimes you just don't know what's going wrong.
I live to serve.
So she's kind of cooking there or something.
Your employee is leveling up.
Will you take the plates now? Oh, finally. Prioritize the plates, please. Why was that so hard to do? They just needed to prioritize that. I'm not really sure how much things they can hold, but... Okay, nice. So let's go here and... We have 3 stars, but no upgrades available. Do I need something to store the plates over here too?
Your employee is leveling up.
Okay, that was completed as well. Serve food in the inn. Sure, we're doing okay right now. Let's just add another table. So expensive to add the table. No, you generally don't want to clog up everything like that. And besides, you can move it a little if you feel like it. That's so easy to do once you know how to do it. I won't move tables with people on them because that might upset them. Now we're just losing money because we ordered all that food and no one is getting any food. The kitchen hand, I don't know what he's doing, but he's not doing his job. What is he doing? I have no idea. So you can also modify the things they do like that. So you can basically put one person to do a certain job and then the others can just, you know, do something else. For example, someone who's like a workaholic. You can just make them do all the cleaning, because that's a problem here. But it's usually better just to leave them do whatever they want in the beginning. Because they have to carry all that stuff inside and I don't want to leave it outside. Let's see, storage. Let's make sure we have enough storage facilities and just make another shelf. Okay, that was about it. I'll just let the video run a few more minutes so everything is okay. Yeah, but this is kind of the complexity you have to expect from it. I did order too much food, but then again, you have only a limited amount of money. So if something goes wrong, you have no chance to make it up or, you know, make enough money to get back in the game.
I'm not too old for this shit, but I'm getting close.
So I guess they just need to set that as a priority, please.
Your patrons need to say your inn is dirty.
To get everything inside and then they'll actually go and do the jobs. Yeah, let's start the party. Oh, what are you guys doing here? Well, the inn is filthy, I know that, but that's... Okay, this is kind of bad. Too many people. Not enough tables. Need to bake more tables. Need to add more tables. What happens if I move a table with people? Well, it doesn't let me move it, so that's one problem solved. Well, I guess they have enough room, okay. What are those guys doing over there, spinning around? I do like the wine, yes, yes. Excellent, I don't know what happened, but he was not happy. Beautiful dress. Let's just tick all the options. We may be insulting them, but who cares?
Your reputation is improving.
Okay, I got the right thing. So how are our profits going? Well, they're going pretty good, as you can see. Onions and that and that. And we're actually cooking the food we need. Okay, I think that was about it. We have seen enough. It's kind of dirty because people keep smoking in here. Imported wine from Sambria. I didn't import anything. But I was having success, man. You just can't leave it alone. Something ends, something
Rockberry
begins.
Rockberry went mad. When Martin got to him, it was already too late.
Look at this.
A torch he'd tossed landed on the roof. The building went up in flames in an instant. Then, during the struggle, Martin's bandage slid off of his arm, revealing a tattoo. A tattoo that would lead up to a series of unexpected events. Meanwhile, the fire that was consuming the inn spread onto the nearby buildings and the vineyard that belonged to Rockberry himself. Terrified, the Duke stood and watched the aftermath of his actions. His senseless revenge was devouring his family's estate right before his eyes. It was the end of him. But it was also the end of the simple life Martin and his nephew had been living on the land belonging to the Duke. old innkeeper knew that if they were to be safe, they needed to find a new home.
That's kind of sad, I know.
You don't have proper equipment. Was it a rat I saw?
Stick this land so far up is. Okay. A new inn, but where? We'll take a loan. Well, that could work, but. Loan of Yorvel. $10,000 should be enough. I mean, if you take more than that. Wow, this is such good interest. I like it. Okay, let's just take $20,000. The loan is so good.
Your reputation is improving.
So I guess that was it, and this is the second mission of the campaign. Let's end the game right here. That is so funny. See you.